What's happening, everybody? Welcome to episode 131 of the Games and Graps podcast. My name is Sonny G, and I'm here, as always, with Finn Steele.
I'm going to toss off so many moves!
I mean, hello.
Hell of a start to the podcast. And
yeah.
Steve is here as well.
Hello.
How's everyone doing? We all good? Well, we know how Finn's doing.
Finn's good.
Yeah. I'm great.
How are the men that you were tossing off?
They seem pleased. They seemed, you know, satisfied.
So, yeah?
Good. Good.
It's the strong arms you're developing from doing Ring Fit.
It is, yeah. Yeah, the stronger there.
Finn, you're a physical specimen.
I am. I'm getting there.
You are getting there.
Look at that. Two tickets to the gun show.
I'll bring you to it.
You're welcome, ladies.
And men. Can we play that soundbite again?
What, this one?
I'm going to toss off so many men!
Danny Bryan, I'm talking smack.
I almost feel the wrestlers don't think before they speak.
Yeah, I bet he's already did that intentionally.
You think?
He had a big smile on his face, and yeah.
I mean, I hope that he knew what he was saying. Because if he didn't, I mean, you know, then we'll just add him to the list of, you know, eating ass and all that sort of stuff. And
tossing off men. And
yeah. Like eating ass is still the weirdest one for me.
Yeah.
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 That's quite.
Yeah.
Stretch his ass like it's never been stretched before.
Yeah.
He's putting body back on knees a little bit.
Double J, Jeff Jarrett there.
Yeah.
Stretching people's asses. What a way to start the podcast, by the way, guys.
Mm. Yeah, pretty great.
Yeah, I mean, that to be honest, it suits us down to a T.
This podcast is rated 18.
Yeah, 100% rated 18.
Just as I was taking a swig of drink then, Jesus.
Oh, man. Right, so we're here for another week, six in a row. I feel like we've fully hit our stride now. We're here every week, and we're back to being a real podcast again.
Yeah.
A real podcast.
Doing it.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing, really.
It is. But,
we had a good week. We've had a good couple of weeks, actually, I think. Views are up and listens are up. And
awesome.
Like, social media stuff's going really well. So we're really grateful. You know, we're not setting the world on fire, but, you know, at the end of the day, we're having a great time. And we hope you guys are still enjoying the show. We're trying to evolve it every week and, you know, keep it interesting and funny and, you know, just keep bringing you that great content.
Hell yeah.
Speaking of. This Sunday, 10 o'clock, so it's Saturday now, so tomorrow or whenever you listen to this podcast, we will be live on Facebook for the NXT Takeover Vengeance Day pre-show before the pre-show.
Oh, yeah.
And then we'll be back the week after for the Elimination Chamber pre-show before the pre-show.
Yeah.
Holy shit, all the pre-shows. So much.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, all the content coming, keeping us busy.
It certainly is. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, but, you know, we're enjoying it, and we hope you guys are as well. Before, you know, we break down the week in wrestling and go through the NXT Takeover predictions and all that sort of stuff, we need to talk video games because, you know, that's what people are here for. People are here for video games as well as wrestling because the two go together so well.
They do.
So, look at this.
Ooh,
I love all this fancy stuff that we've got now. It makes us look way better than we actually are.
It's getting the
we're punching. Sound. We're definitely punching.
Oh, 100% we're punching. It's like it makes us definitely seem like a more professional outfit. When really we're just three idiots who think, you know, eating ass and dick jokes are really funny.
They're pretty funny. Let's admit.
They are funny, actually. Yeah. There's no we can't make any bones about it.
No. I don't remember that episode, but back it down.
Oh man, right. Finn Steele.
Hello.
What have you been playing this week?
I've mostly been playing Spider-Man, Miles Morales on PS5.
Awesome.
Yeah, really good. I've been hammering it, trying to get through it. as quick as I can, doing all like side quests and things as I go.
Mm. Okay.
And yeah, it's really good. War Spider-Man, some join. First game was really good, obviously.
Yeah.
It's all the same. Really enjoying the story. And yeah, just really, really good. Another really, really good video game, but PS4. Five.
Yeah. Five, yeah. And four. It's on four as well.
Yeah, yeah.
How far into the story are you without sort of giving away any spoilers?
So I think I've done pretty much all the little side quests, and they're all done now. So pretty much near the end, I think.
Okay. Are you obviously going for the platinum?
Yeah, of course. It's me you're talking about. but yeah, go for the platinum trophy. Don't you play again on New Game Plus for the trophy for platinum?
Yeah, but you can absolutely like hammer through it. I think, you know, it's doable in like 5-6 hours, the story. You just mainline it. Because, you know, I know you have to sort of wait a little bit in between quests sometimes. Like, you know, it wants you to go and do side stuff. But if you just ignore all of that, it'll just sort of carry on with the story. So you can blast through it in about 6 hours. That's what I did. I just hammered through it.
Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, more of that. The only little complaint I'll have is that a lot of the missions feel pretty much the same. Like one mission you'll be, you know, the start up with a room full of men. Nice. And you got to try and take them all down stealthily or just jump in and fight everyone. And the next mission, you'll do the same thing. And the next one, you'll change it again. But yeah, it's still fun. I'm still enjoying it. And, you know, it's not a bad thing.
I like the with Miles Morales. I like the addition of the new powers. I feel like that makes a huge difference. And then sort of going back to like Spider-Man, the one that came out like 2018, 2017, whichever one it was. Like, you know, he feels like a real basic bitch.
Yeah, exactly. You have any like cool electric powers?
Yeah.
Boring.
But I really like the electric powers. And then, obviously, are you playing on performance with ray tracing? Or are you
On, like, the highest graphical thing. Because you kind of get used to 30 frames a second after a while. It just looks so pretty. I could not.
But wait till you see it, performance with ray tracing.
Yeah, I've done that as well. Tried it all.
It's insane. I think I can't go back to 30 frames per second now I've played that.
I know, it's good, it's tempting, but yeah, I keep switching between the two, like different games, and like, they're both really good, I like them both. Yeah. It looks so good, it doesn't feel so good, it's so smooth. But yeah, depends what I'm into, I guess, at the time.
Yeah, true. So, you know when you're in like a room full of men, what's the first thing you do?
Well, first thing I do is...
I'm going to toss off so many men!
And then...
And you see that one final man in there. What are you thinking?
But yeah,
you could have used the stretch his ass out one.
This one.
Like it's never been stretched before.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Hell yeah!
Which one do I choose? yeah.
He's tossed all the other ones off and he's going to stretch that one out.
Yeah, exactly. why do people listen to this?
I don't know. I genuinely don't know.
It's a mystery. Yeah, other than Spider-Man, more Ori and the Will of the Wrists.
How are you getting on with that?
Yeah, pretty good. I haven't played it a whole lot this week. I'm trying to get through Spider-Man. But yeah, I'm still enjoying it. Still an amazing looking game.
Yeah.
So good.
Good.
And yeah, that's about it, really.
Excellent. Steve, what have you been playing?
So I've been mainly playing the stupidly addictive Animal Crossing on the Nintendo Switch.
Nice.
I've just losing hours to it. Oh, I'm gone. That's it.
Head's gone.
Fully addicted. Head's gone. Head's completely gone. It's just quite relaxing, isn't it? It's a really relaxing game. You just sit there for hours. Before you know, relaxing. You've done 4 hours. And... 4 or 5 hours of catching butterflies and going fishing.
Yeah.
What am I doing with my life? No, I'm joking. It's a great game. I can see why it's so popular. And the only other thing that I've really been playing, we played Sea of Thieves on
Thursday. We can't get enough of it. We're just addicted to the seas. We cannot stop playing. We love it.
Yeah. Yeah. So we're
addicted to the loot that means absolutely nothing.
Yeah. Yeah, you can't upgrade your weapons or anything like that. But
it's all cosmetic stuff.
Hey,
we want all that loot. We need to buy new missions and new clothes for our pirates, and that is it.
Yeah. That's it.
Yeah. That's literally it. Yeah.
No. Give ourselves a stupid beard or a crap tattoo or whatever, but
yeah, a bit of face paint, look like a pirate David Bowie. Yeah, why not?
Like a shit Jeff Hardy. So me, you, and Darren the Melt Hook were playing that on Thursday. There's your mention. Yeah.
He wants a mention. He loves a mention. Yeah, he loves to be sort of shoehorned in. We get him on the podcast, but he's just boring as shit.
Oh, he's so shook as well, isn't he? Plus, we'd have to put subtitles along the bottom.
Yeah, for people like who can't understand like the North.
Because he misses out every other word.
Hello, welcome to Games and Graps podcast. This is exactly what it would sound like. if you want North, we're sorry. He's the only one we take the piss out of.
Yeah, the rest of you are fine. It's just him.
Just him.
Not really, Darren. We love you. That's it, really. That's it. Sonny's turning his face up. I don't know about love. No, I don't. No, you're a melt.
We tolerate.
Yeah. So that's it, really. Not had a lot of time to actually do gaming between wrestling and football and family. So
family last there. I like that.
Yeah.
Football and wrestling and family as well, I guess. Yeah.
Works below family, if that helps.
At least they're not last. That's the main thing.
They go down the... It depends. Day to day. It changes day to day. Sometimes it's like, oh, what an amazing day with the family. Then other days it's... No.
Yeah, today I'm just going to dig up weeds and catch butterflies. That's what I'm going to do today.
Yeah, instead.
Yeah, definitely. Let me ask you a question about Animal Crossing.
Go for it.
I think it's one of those games that really helped a lot of people during the start of lockdown, you know, take their sort of mind off everything. They were able to sort of get lost in it. Do you feel like it's one of those games that, you know, really does soothe and help in terms of like mental health?
I wouldn't say it's had that effect on me as such. But I can definitely see how it would help people. Because the thing that's lacking at the minute, obviously, with everything that's going on, is interaction with other people.
Yeah.
Unless it's over things like Zoom or whatever you're using. And I know that, obviously, using Animal Crossing, it's a virtual thing and, you know, it's not real life. But it gives you that sense of being outside, doesn't it? It's really weird. So I can 100% see how it's helping people through this lockdown and helping with people's mental health. And it's because it's just a fun game as well. Not that it ever should be, but sometimes gaming can really piss you off. It can really annoy you, you know, if you can't get through
Crash
a level or something. Yeah, exactly.
PTSD.
It's just a nice game to play, isn't it?
It is, yeah. I mean, Finn, you've played it. Did you find sort of it helped in that sense?
Yeah, it certainly takes your mind off things. I didn't get into it as much as some people. I played it a lot when I first got it, and that's got kind of distracted by other things. But as Steve said, I can definitely see how it would help, you know, people do other things. Especially you can like visit other people in their villages and things like that and share things. Because I think definitely would help with things like that.
Yeah, 100%. It's just a super relaxing game, super cute as well. And, you know, it's not one of them things you really need to stress about, or you're literally just digging up, you know, weeds and stuff. Like we've said, it's literally digging up weeds, catching butterflies and various other bugs, going fishing, and then finding stuff to put in your house.
Yeah.
And getting fleeced by that raccoon guy, or whatever he is. What is he? Is he a squirrel or is he a badger? I don't know. He's not a badger,
I think it's a raccoon. Oh, no, it's a tanuki.
He's a what?
I think it's a tanuki, is he?
Is that a real thing?
Yeah.
Is it a real thing?
It is.
A tanuki is a real thing?
Yeah, it's a Japanese thing. Hold on.
No. Yeah, I mean real as in actually real.
Yeah, it's a little raccoon thing.
Okay. Well, it makes sense if his name's Tom Nook.
Yeah, that's a good point. There you go. Tanuki, yeah.
Yeah, because obviously there's a Tanuki Mario as well, which I just thought was a cat.
Yeah. Yeah, Japanese raccoon dog. It's cute.
Japanese what?
Raccoon dog.
Of course.
It's cute.
Of course, they've got a raccoon dog. Are they native to Japan? Are they?
Yeah, I think so.
Right.
Good stuff. Every day is a school day.
Yeah. Every day is a school day, and the Games and Graps podcast is educating you. It's educating us, to be fair. I mean,
it is. Yeah.
You're welcome.
I've been playing quite a lot of WWE 2K Battlegrounds this week. In fact, for the last couple of weeks, I forgot to mention it last week, but I don't know what. I've been like super addicted to it, just like unlocking the wrestlers. Like, I don't even know why.
Yeah, it's one of those like you just want to catch them all kind of thing, isn't it?
It is, yeah. And I've just been really enjoying like the gameplay. I've been playing it on Switch and I've been playing it on Xbox.
Wow.
Yeah, I know. Like if I'm like just sitting around and like there's something on the TV and I've got my Switch in my hand, I'm just like flicking between that and Wrestling Empire.
Yeah, nice. I need to check it out. So I keep seeing
things. You do need to check it out. I know I say it every week, but you do need to.
Yeah.
A quick update on that. I left All American Wrestling.
Oh, yeah.
As their United States champion, and I took their championship to Strong Style Wrestling. They weren't happy with me, naturally. Yeah, because I left as their champion in, you know, somewhat of a Medusa moment on WCW. But yeah, now I'm a tag team champion with the games version of Austin Aries in Strong Style Wrestling, which is I'm still really enjoying myself with it. I just love that you're just making my own story in the game.
Yeah,
that's cool. That tag team won't last not with Austin Aries.
No, definitely not. I've done a bit of now. I've been changing the names of the ones that I know who they are.
Right.
As well, just to give it a bit more of a real feel. The names are funny.
So it's got an editor mode then? Like.
Yeah, you can edit the names stuff like that, yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I'm still really enjoying that. Definitely check it out.
Yeah, I'm going to, it's payday Monday, so I might treat myself.
Get in.
Pick up the money.
Plus, you've got that thing that I told you about with the Switch cartridges.
Yes, of course.
Have you tried that yet?
Not yet, no.
I'm sure you know this, but you know if you put a Switch cartridge into your Switch,
mm-hmm.
Scroll down to Nintendo Rewards.
Oh, yeah.
And it gives you actual money to spend on the Nintendo store.
Oh, really? Oh, shit.
Yeah.
I could dig out my collection, go through them today, I think, and get those.
Yeah, literally every game that you've got will, you just scroll down to Nintendo Rewards and you basically, you know, so when you buy digital, you get money back.
Yeah,
well, it's the same thing if you buy physical, you do it and it gives you some coins back.
Oh, awesome.
Does it depend on the game or is it the same? Is it a set amount?
Think like sort of Nintendo first party games give you more.
Okay.
Some of the games give you less, but still it's money that you didn't have, I guess.
Yeah.
So, cool. Although Nintendo games, you know, are super expensive, at least they try and give you something back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Speaking of Nintendo games, before we came on the podcast today, I played some Super Mario 3D World.
Nice. Again, a lot
of really good.
Yeah. It looks pretty good. Yeah.
It's really good. I'm glad I didn't play it on the Wii U. But the Wii U is still a banging console. I don't care.
Yeah. It's all right. Underrated.
There's nothing wrong with it. I mean, yeah, the stupid massive tablet thing probably didn't need to be that big. But, you know, as a console, it wasn't a bad console at all.
No. But, it's a great game. I see lots of positive reviews for it. Have you tried the Bowser's Fury mode yet?
Not yet, no. I only started playing it today. I did the first world and the first level of the second world. Cool. But it's great. It's, you know, it blends so many different things. Like, it's cool that it's got like Captain Toad segments in there as well, and you know, you're basically it's Mario. You're on the quest for, you know, you can get stars, and so you need the stars to unlock the levels, and yeah, great game. Highly recommend it.
Cool. I'll definitely pick it up at some point.
Yeah, that and Wrestling Revolution, Wrestling Empire.
Yeah, for sure.
I want us to be able to do a podcast where we discuss our Wrestling Empire careers and the trajectory that they're taking.
That'd be really cool, actually. Yeah, we should do that.
We should absolutely do that. Just a Wrestling Empire episode.
Yeah.
Mm. That'd be cool.
Yeah, that'd be awesome. But otherwise, I've been sort of not playing an awful lot. I mean, most of my hours have gone into Wrestling Empire and Battlegrounds, and today I played Mario, played a couple of games of FIFA and a bit of Sea of Thieves. But yeah, I'm yeah, I'm just enjoying gaming on all the platforms that I have. So it's nice to have that mix, and it's still a great time to be a gamer, and I'm really, really enjoying it.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Good stuff.
So there's not been a great deal of gaming news this week.
Yeah, I can remember.
The biggest gaming news this week was the announcement of the release date for Ratchet and Clank, Rift Apart.
Yeah.
Which comes out in April, question mark?
That sounds right.
April the 11th, I think. I think I've got that right. I'm not 100% sure, but it's soon-ish.
Yeah.
April the 11th.
It looks great. I mean, I think it's going to be awesome. I love the last one. I love the one on the PS4.
Yeah. I haven't played that yet, don't think.
You've not played it?
No, I got it. It's one of those ones you buy and then don't play.
Oh, Finn, you dick. You've got to play it. Right, next week when we come on this podcast, I want you to have played it.
Okay, I will play it.
I can't believe you haven't played it.
Yeah, I don't know. It's one that slipped through the cracks, I guess. I don't know.
No. No. I cannot believe you've not played it. For someone who loves like platformers and stuff like that, and you've not played that, but one of the best games on the PlayStation 4.
Finn, even I've played it.
Wow. I'm that fine.
Finn!
I'll play it and I'll attempt to platinum it if it's easy.
It is an easy platinum. It's, well, I say easy. It's it takes a bit of graft, but not Crash Bandicoot craft. Graft.
Yeah. Okay, let's check it out.
Right, next week I want you to have played Ratchet and Clank, a Rift, whatever it's called in.
It's my homework for this week.
Yes, it is. That is your homework this week. Yeah.
That and Wrestling Empire.
That and Wrestling Empire. Yep.
Cool. Got it. Next, I'll report back next week.
I can't believe you've not played that.
Yeah, I can't.
That just surprised me.
Yeah, well, I was thinking about it. Yeah, I'll play that. I thought, wait, no, I haven't.
But yeah, it's basically like a playable Pixar movie. It is wonderful.
Mm. Yeah, I played ages ago on PS3. I played like a collection. Mm. So yeah, some reason I never got around to a new one. Oh,
which
yeah,
you will.
Yeah, I will. And it said, yeah, you're right. June 11th for the new one.
June 11th.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So not as soon as I thought. Actually, I thought it was April.
Oh yeah, yeah.
But, April the 11th. WrestleMania weekend, I think.
Yes, it is. Yeah. Yeah.
Cool.
10th, 11th.
I'm looking forward to WrestleMania this year. Yeah, definitely, yeah. I'm looking forward to that. We'll do the pre-shows and the pods.
Absolutely.
Get all the content that week.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll do some sort of special WrestleMania week stuff.
Yeah, we should.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Definitely.
Yeah.
We'll figure it out and then we'll do it.
That will be that'll be a busy one because you've effectively got two pre-shows, haven't you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I imagine there's an NXT takeover that weekend as well, probably on the Friday.
I don't know if there will be because they're talking about a couple of the titles being at
defended
at
WrestleMania.
Yeah,
they
could still fill a card, but
maybe the Saturday could be NXT Takeover WrestleMania.
Yeah, that's not a bad shout.
Yeah,
imagine that shit. That would be absolutely awesome.
Yeah,
cut down on all the crap as well. But there we go.
Yeah, definitely.
Booking WrestleMania weekend.
Yeah,
we book WrestleMania, NXT Takeover WrestleMania for night one. And then night two, if you really have to, you can have Apollo Crews versus Big E. That's fine.
Yeah. Awesome battle royal so everyone gets their payday.
Yeah.
That's the one thing I don't like about WrestleMania these days. I love WrestleMania weekend. I as a wrestling fan of a long, long time, it's the one thing I do really get excited for more than anything else wrestling wise. But I don't like that they have to shoehorn everybody in now. I'd rather, it be done on performance basis, with the direction that the storylines are going. Like, have the biggest storylines culminate on the biggest stage. That's what I think should happen.
Yeah, Jeff Hardy versus Elias. The biggest storyline going wrestling right now. and that's been for like 5 months now.
Yeah. Absolutely awful.
Yeah, terrible.
Absolutely awful. I'm trying to think of if there's been any other gaming news that's like of any sort of note.
Yeah, I've been looking through GameSpot. I can't really see my GameSpot all that good, but
gaming, you're really boring at the minute.
Yeah.
Like for news at least. Like the actual gaming side of things is great. But you know, for news and stuff. Keep, you know, give us something.
Yeah. Nothing really major.
No, not at all. I mean, I know that Marvel's Avengers, they've got like a war table on the 16th, so Tuesday. And I think they're 100% going to sort of announce the release date, which I would imagine is imminent for the PlayStation 5 / Xbox Series X / S version, because the trophies have already been leaked and they're already live somewhere. So I would imagine it might even be the updates available now type thing once that war table's done. And also they're announcing Hawkeye, but you know, that's really as much as I can figure out in terms of gaming news.
Yeah.
But I'm definitely going to jump back into the Avengers when the update comes out. I've got it on my PS4 now, but I'm going to wait until the update's out now.
Yeah, they've got some work to do to bring people back, but I think they can do it.
I think they can do it. I think the next gen update will definitely bring people in.
Yeah, for sure.
I mean, people should play it just for the campaign. I mean, I know I said it on here, but I think the campaign was fantastic. It really was.
Yeah, and it's been on sale quite a few times since then, so.
Yeah, I mean, it's worth a look for the campaign alone, I think.
Cool.
For sure. Right, so not much gaming news. We've talked about what we've been playing. So before we go into the wrestling side of our podcast, it's time for round 3 of the Eliminator.
Here we go.
So Steve is currently trailing 2-0 to Mr. Steele, the worst winner in the history of winners.
I mean, if you want to stop now, just let me the money, you can, you know, save all the hassle.
No.
there's still life left in this, I'm sure.
Okay, fair enough.
One thing that I do remember before we go into the Eliminator, Crash Bandicoot is getting a PS5 and Xbox Series X upgrade.
Which means you can automatically pop the trophies and get a second platinum, which is the only reason I'm going to play it. Maybe check out the new graphics.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that, to be honest. I've got it on Xbox Series X. I just want to... Well, I've got it on Xbox, but I'm going to wait for the update before I really go back and play it again. But yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing what that looks like.
Yeah. The quick load times would be nice, because it did take a while to load sometimes, especially if you restart the level every 5 minutes like I was.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or 30 seconds or something.
It's because you suck.
Yeah. I'd say you try and get it.
No, I wouldn't be able to get it. I'm not saying I'm better than that, because I'm not, but there's no way I would get it. But if I did, I'd probably get it in less time than you. But
ooh, that sounds like a challenge.
It does.
No, don't ever take that as
a challenge. Well,
it's not happening. Right. Question number 1.
He moved on quickly then, didn't he, Finn?
He did.
I'm not doing that shit.
A single flat. That's your challenge. Just
what's
one.
That?
I needed to unlock one single platinum time trial relic in any level you want.
Just I've already done it like 3 times.
What, platinum relic?
Yeah.
No, yeah. Don't mind.
Completed it, mate.
All right.
Right. Question number 1.
The music. Love it. So good.
When this podcast first started, sorry Finn, to cut you off there. When this podcast first started, it was so bare bones, it was ridiculous.
Yeah.
It was literally me and Finn sat across a table from one another talking into an iPad.
Yeah, exactly.
There was none of this like fancy stuff that we use now with the sound effects and all that. It was literally that. Me and Finn sat talking over an iPad.
Yeah.
Eventually, you know, we upgraded to microphones and then we took over the world. It was great.
Yeah.
Anyway. Question number 1.
Welcome to my TED talk. There you go.
The Undertaker's WrestleMania undefeated streak started at WrestleMania 7. But who was the Undertaker's first victim? Was it A, Jake the Snake Roberts? Was it B, Superfly Jimmy Snuka? Was it C, the Giant Gonzalez? Or was it D, King Kong Bundy?
Good question. I think it's one of the two. I'm going to go with Jake the Snake.
Ooh. I'm going to go with C,
The answer was Superfly Jimmy Snuka. So neither of you.
Wow.
Wow.
Both of you lose a life.
We suck.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was WrestleMania 7. Superfly Jimmy Snuka was The Undertaker's 1-0.
Wow. Fair enough.
There we go. The second one was Jake the Snake Roberts. The third one was the Giant Gonzalez. In that fucking terrible bodysuit that he wore. So bad.
Was that WrestleMania 9? Which is
yes, it was WrestleMania
9. Widely regarded as pretty crap anyway.
Yeah. Hey, I will not have you talk shit about WrestleMania 9. Jim Ross in a toga is phenomenal.
I said widely regarded. I have no opinion.
Have you not seen it?
I think one way or the other.
Yeah, I probably have. I probably watched the main event.
Maybe we should do like a watch along of WrestleMania 9 at some point.
Yeah, maybe.
Like maybe that could be one of the things in the build up to WrestleMania.
Yeah, we can do that.
Yeah, watch along. That'd be up for that.
Yeah, we'll do a watch along. That'd be great.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, cool. That sounds good. Okay. Right. Question number two. You are both down a life.
Yes.
Panda first appears as a selectable fighter in which game in the Tekken franchise? Was it Tekken 2? Tekken Tag Tournament? Tekken 3 or Tekken 4?
I'm going to go for A, Tekken 2.
Okay.
Something's telling me it's Tekken Tag Tournament, but I don't know why.
Okay. Final answer?
Final answer.
Okay. The answer is Tekken 3. You are both wrong.
I think it was in Tekken Tag Tournament, wasn't he?
Yes, he was. Yeah. He was Tekken Tag, but that was after Tekken 3.
Yeah. Fair enough. Don.
Oof. Bad start for the two of you, this.
It is. Not the best.
Okay, question number three. Bret Hart and Owen Hart fought each other in the first match of which WrestleMania? WrestleMania 8, WrestleMania 10, WrestleMania 11, or WrestleMania 12?
I don't know.
That can't be an answer. That's not a WrestleMania. WrestleMania, I don't know, wasn't one of them. No.
Let's go with WrestleMania 12.
Finn says WrestleMania 12. Steve?
I'm going to go WrestleMania 10.
The answer is WrestleMania 10.
No. My point.
Fun fact about WrestleMania 10, Bret Hart fought twice that night.
Did he?
He fought Yokozuna in the main event as well for the heavyweight championship. Because Lex Luger fought him, and then Bret Hart fought him. Because both of them were eliminated from the Royal Rumble at the same time. You know, one of that usually finish.
Fair play.
Yeah. All right. So, Finn, you've lost three lives so far.
I'm not doing well. Finn
has two lives remaining. Okay. I like how you've started the question music and...
I'm sorry, yeah. I was ready to go straight into it.
Yeah, no, I was doing a bit of reading.
Ah.
There we go. Right, I'm ready. Next question. Yeah. With more than 80 million copies sold, what was the best-selling game on the Nintendo Wii?
Oh. It's got to be... Count.
Keep it to yourself until you've both got an answer.
I have an answer, but I don't know if it counts as a game sold or because it's a bundled in game.
Mm.
I thought that would be more than 80 whatever's Well, you talked about this not too long ago as well.
Yep. I'm gonna rush you here, guys, for an answer.
I'll take TGA 5, but that wasn't on the way.
It might be now. I mean, they probably ported it.
Probably. Oh, it's got to be Mario Kart, right?
Okay, so is that your final answer?
That's my final answer.
That's okay.
Yeah, I was gonna go. Yeah, I was gonna go Mario Kart as well. That was my answer.
Okay. With 80 million copies sold, the biggest selling game on the Nintendo Wii was Wii Sports.
I didn't go for that because of what I thought about the bundled game thing. Yeah, it makes sense.
Finn, think about it like this. Not every single Wii console came with Wii Sports.
Pretty sure it did.
The black one didn't come with Wii Sports. It came with Wii Sports Resort.
Fair enough.
Finn, you've got one life left.
What's the second best-selling game?
I don't know. This is from an actual video game quiz.
Can't even bother to think up your own questions.
No. I bought this video game quiz for the sole purpose of doing it like this.
Yeah. Yes, the second best-selling game was, in fact, Mario Kart Wii. So,
how many?
It's Mario Kart Wii for 37 million.
Well, that's not 80 million, and if you're not first,
Jesus.
You're last.
So... That's a huge gap, that is. Jesus.
It was bundled in, it doesn't count.
Well, it does count, because it's still a game. Could you not buy Wii Sports separately?
Yeah, I guess you could.
I think yeah, you could. Definitely.
There you go, then. It's a game, isn't it? Hey, look.
Rob, damn it.
Look, I know you're fuming at that, but that's a real answer.
I guess. It's fine.
You've got one life left.
Fine.
And Steve, you have two lives left. And we have...
Time for the comeback.
Time for the comeback?
Injury.
Okay. Right. Just having a quick look here.
You're going to pick a question like you know I won't know the answer to.
Huh?
You're going to pick a question now you know I don't know the answer to.
No, not necessarily.
What is Steve's birthday?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Yep. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. Corvo Atano is a protagonist of which video game series?
What's the name again?
Corvo Atano.
Corvo.
Is it A, Thief? Is it B, Dishonored? 50-50.
Corvo. I've heard the name. Now you've said both games, I'm like, yeah, I recognize that. But I can't remember Thief or Dishonored. I'm going to go with my gut and say Thief.
Okay. Steve?
I'm going to go Thief as well.
The answer is Dishonored.
Damn. Impossible. I think Finn, right.
You are out of lives. Steve, wow. Congratulations.
I've got to be honest, I went tactical there.
You went tactical?
Yeah.
Because if he got that wrong, and I'll just copy what he says, and then, you know, I knew he only had one life left.
We cheated.
No, it's tactical.
Cheated? Why cheated?
Well, if I didn't say that, I'd have said Dishonored. I'd have been right anyway. So,
yeah,
definitely. Here we go. You're still winning, Finn. You still win. It's still 2-1.
He's the worst winner, and also the worst loser as well.
Yeah. Surprised you're not a Man United fan. Sorry. Yeah.
Ooh.
You know, I'm
that last one is a bit of a weird one, I think. I mean, it literally could have been either of them, really.
Yeah. Like I said, I recognize the name. I knew it was like a stealth game.
Yeah. Is it the fact that I threw Thief in there that threw you off?
I think so, yeah. Must be
that. I'm just glad you went multiple choice because I don't have a frigging clue.
Yeah, me too. I thought you were the same thing.
No, I wouldn't have known that. I wouldn't have known that at all.
I would have gone like... Metal Gear Solid 8 or something. I don't
know. All right. So, Finn, you lose this week, but you are still leading the series 2-1.
Cool.
That's congratulations, fine. Steve. You are you've brought yourself back into it.
Yeah, I'm just glad I've got one on the board, to be honest. I think if I'd have gone 3-0 down, that's it. Mentally, I'd have been gone. And I think that would have been it for me.
Plenty of weeks left in the year.
Plenty of weeks left in the year. I think we series of this. I think we go... I think we do up until a certain pay-per-view. I think we go up to WrestleMania with this series.
Yeah.
Okay, and then the winner of this series drops out and then brings me in and I go against the loser in the next series.
And then the series after that, winner versus winner.
Yes.
Unless
yeah. Versus winner twice. Yeah. Because then, yeah, that works. That works.
Yeah.
Then we'll find out who the ultimate loser of Games and Graps is, which will probably be me. So,
if we all win, what we should do is we should bring in a special guest quizmaster.
Yeah, good idea.
Yeah, so we'll do that. So this series of the Eliminator, Steve versus Finn, will go up until WrestleMania.
Yeah.
Then after that, I will come in and take on the loser of that series while the winner asks the questions.
Cool.
Okay.
And we take that up until SummerSlam?
Sure. That works.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. And then after SummerSlam, we'll do the ultimate round.
The ultimate.
Yeah. There we go. That sounds good. That sounds good. Okay. So
forward planning.
I'm out of love to see. Want to see.
That I love that woo in the background.
Great.
All right, so the week in wrestling. I tell you, we've not heard from in a little while. It's Cockney friend.
Yeah. Where's he gone?
Hey, there he is. Getting all to high score, bloke.
No, still no.
Yeah, it's still no.
No, it's still no.
It'll always be no. Yeah.
Yeah, sorry, bloke.
Finn, have you played the Tony Hawk remaster yet?
I haven't actually, no. One day.
What are you doing?
I did like the Zenimal games, obviously, as everyone did back in the 90s, last 2000s.
Do you think you've outgrown them?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I mean, I haven't had that desire to go back. But,
that's fair.
Yeah.
I think the reason that I did go back, and like probably the reason so many did go back, is it was just like a pivotal part of like growing up.
Yeah, absolutely. Music especially, like.
Oh, God, yeah. That's the music I still listen to now.
Yeah, same here.
There's a huge amount of nostalgia attached to that remaster, wasn't there? And it played so well as well. It was
God, it's incredible.
I would like to play it someday.
It was really good. I really enjoyed it. I'm crap at it, but I really, really enjoyed it.
How far did you get in?
Oh, I can't remember now. Can't remember, but it's just, yeah. It was cool.
I'm still playing it, but I'm too anal with it. Like, I want to I want to make sure that I get everything that I need to get before I move on to the next level. But that's really difficult at times.
Mm. Yeah, some of it was. That's a game that can frustrate you. If we go back
definitely,
to what we were talking about earlier, that was definitely a game that I was getting quite frustrated with. But
yeah, if that was on the Switch, the Switch would be snapped over your leg.
Oh yeah, the Switch would be gone now.
Yeah, be in the sea.
Definitely.
Right, let's move on to the week in wrestling. It is the week of NXT Takeover Vengeance Day, and we will be going through our predictions just a little bit later on in the show. But as always, I guess we have to start with Monday Night Raw.
Do we have to?
Well, we don't have to, but I guess the listeners want to hear us say how shit Raw is, how it's too long, and how it has no real direction, but you know, we'll talk about it anyway.
Sure.
Steve, you got notes?
I got a few notes, got a few.
Okay,
bits.
Well, okay, you've got more notes than I have if you've only got a few notes.
There's a notice. Shit.
So we started out, Shane McMahon came out. That was a surprise.
The money,
here comes the money. And he announced that there was going to be announces the Elimination Chamber match and who's going to be in it. Mm. And the names completely escape me. So it's
Hardy, it's all former AJ champions, Styles, isn't it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Jeff Hardy, AJ Styles, Randy Orton, Sheamus, and Drew himself. Is he actually
Drew himself? Yeah, and The Miz.
In the Elimination Chamber and The Miz.
Yes.
Yeah. So it's, that's what it is. It is a Elimination Chamber full of former champions and the current champion, which obviously Sheamus wasn't too happy about because he was hoping for a singles shot, singles match against Drew, but now he's got to go up against five other blokes.
Oh, I wonder what he's going to do when he. Wonder what he's going to do when he sees them five other blokes.
I mean, he's going to
toss off so many moves.
Oh, that'd be an interesting pay per view.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, I wonder what's going to happen when he gets to the last man, the last two.
I'm
going to come on you like nobody's ever come on you before.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
I'm so happy that we have this.
Yeah.
It just makes me so happy. I think that match is... I think it'd be a good match.
Yeah, I feel like kind of a meh list of superstars. Nothing against any of them, but I feel like they could have thrown in some new guys like Keith Lee and guys like that.
Well, I think it's because the former champions won. That's why they've gone in that direction.
Yeah, I guess.
Because they
I know. It's just like a bit of a cop out. I get that.
Yeah.
They jumped on that straight away. I think the first advertisement of it after one of the breaks, Michael, was one of the tagline that Michael Cole gave it was it's full of former champions. They're all former champions. So that's obviously the tagline that they've gone with. The Shane part of it, I'm not really sure what the Shane dynamic is there because he came out of the ring and was pointing at Adam Pearce as if to say, well, yeah, this was all your idea.
Yeah,
so it's almost like he's deflecting the blame. But where's Shane come from? Is he still involved? What is he? Is he now Raw General? I don't know. What's going on?
Don't know. Maybe he's just turning up for Raw Overground.
Christ. But yeah, we had AJ Styles versus Jeff Hardy. Okay, fine. Jeff Hardy tapped.
Jeff Hardy doesn't win matches, does he? Really?
No.
Not anymore.
No, AJ doesn't lose.
A bit like Rey Mysterio.
Yeah.
Rey Mysterio doesn't win matches either.
Hey, lost on... Did he lose last night?
He did
lose last night. Yeah, he did.
Yeah.
New Day versus Retribution.
Why do they keep making them lose? Like, they knew they weren't even, like, even seeing threatened. They're, like, smiling and dancing to the whole thing. Like, why are you burying these people?
Yeah, I feel like it. I feel like Retribution is it's lost any sort of direction. It lost the no direction it already had. So, I think Ali is great.
Yeah, great on the mic. Great.
Yeah, I think he is. Yeah, he was really good.
The rest of them were good anyway.
Mm. Yeah,
you can still have, Ali as a heel, but you just have Dijakovic be Dijakovic. You have Nutsack go back into being Mia Yim.
Yeah.
Dio Madden's a big, intimidating looking guy. He doesn't need the mask and stuff.
No.
And Shane Thorne, I enjoyed as well. And I thought they were really going somewhere with him and the other big Australian dude that they called up from NXT way too quick to pair up with him on Raw.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the guy with no elbow pads and knee pads, that really annoys me. I don't know why. I can't remember his name, but he had knee pads or no elbow pads.
Yeah.
But, Shane Thorne, I always liked. I always liked TM61 when they were a tag team.
Cool.
But I don't know. Retribution now, it's... I don't, maybe it wasn't ever any good. It wasn't, was it, really? The best thing about them, like you said, Steve, is their T-shirt. But...
Yeah, T-shirt's cool. That's about it.
Yeah, the T-shirt is really cool. I'll probably buy it when Retribution split up and it goes on sale. I think, Ali can be successful on his own. I think he should just sort of still be a heel, banish them, and then they all come back and... do their own thing.
Yeah.
I think it's a shame. It felt like it had potential with this whole hacker thing that Ali had going on. Retribution for a start, when they were coming out and cutting the ropes and things like that, it had potential. You thought, oh, this could be really cool. And then for me, it kind of just died on its arse when they were drafted to Raw. It's like, hang on, these guys are trying to be like anti-establishment, anti-WWE, anti-we're not going to listen to you.
Yeah.
But then it's like, well, you're going to exclusively be on Raw. Okay, no problem. It just felt a bit like, nah, you've kind of ruined it a bit there. And then the names and the stupid mask probably didn't help either. Or definitely didn't help. So.
Oh, yeah. It's the names are terrible. We could, you know, take the piss out of it till the cows come home. I mean, I think, to be honest, for me, it was ruined from the start because WWE that day that Retribution turned up, you know, it was announced that they were coming.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or that somebody was coming, like a new faction was coming.
Hmm. Yeah, strange. Very strange. So after that, we had Ric Flair and Lacey Evans cutting a promo. Can't get my words out. A promo. I'm that like enthusiastic about it. I can't even get my words out. My notes here say Rick and Lacey cut a promo. Rick looks like shit. The guy looks so ill and he's like face is just so red. Like, dude, just go and retire. Just go and chill. Like, man, like I know you've got like 58 kids and 19 wives to pay off, but like go and chill.
Yeah.
The promo's pretty bad but Lacey pulls it around. She's great. She's fantastic.
I love Lacey. I think she's awesome, yeah.
She's really good. She's always been pretty good on the mic. Her in-ring stuff has gotten loads better as well. Lacey via Ric Flair calls out Oscar, saying that they've been granted a title shot against Oscar if Lacey wins her next match, which was against Charlotte. They have the match, and it's thrown out because Charlotte puts her hands on the ref and didn't break the five count effectively.
Mm-hmm. So Charlotte gets disqualified.
Yeah, so technically Lacey wins. So that's why the title shot. I've seen a lot of people complaining about this online and stuff. That actually fits with the story. The story is you'll get a title shot if you win. She won.
Yeah, makes sense.
Yeah, doesn't matter how you win. Just if you win, you win. That's it.
Yeah. Personally, I think where this is heading is that match happens, but Charlotte comes down to attack Lacey. Oscar gets pissed off with her, and then we end up with potentially a triple threat at WrestleMania for Oscar's title.
Yeah.
Charlotte wins.
Charlotte wins, lol. So.
Yeah.
That's
I'm fine with it. I don't really mind it. I'm fine with it.
It'll be fine. It'll be a fine match. It'll be fine. And that's the thing with Raw. It does. I know you said like there's no direction or anything. I can see where storylines are heading and different things like that. It's just the show itself just doesn't feel very well put together and it's drawn out, isn't it? That's the problem.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the big issue with it. Yeah, it's not very well put together at all. They've got all the talent in the world there, and they're not really doing much of anything with it. It's crap.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Right.
So then we had Edge coming out, cutting a promo. Miz comes and interrupts him and says that whoever he faces at WrestleMania, he's going to cash in on him. To which Edge says, interesting. You've just told me your whole plans for what you're going to do. Whereas I'm keeping what I'm going to do quite closely guarded. And he's still not made that decision. That's not been made, which I'm not mad about. WrestleMania's quite a few weeks away. Go all the time in the world.
Yeah, long time away. Yeah, he's going to announce it after the Elimination Chamber, isn't he? That's the big thing. He's going to announce it after the, you know, when the dust has settled on the Elimination Chamber was the words he used, I think. Yeah. And yeah, okay, that's fine.
Which does make sense because it when it's announced, so when they announce it that night, someone wins the Royal Rumble. They're in the ring, blowing out their ass. So who are you going to face? I think I'm going to go for. They can't, you know. They're absolutely knackered. There's usually two pay-per-views in between.
Yeah.
So you're almost precursoring what's going to happen with those pay-per-views when it gets announced on the night. So I'm not. I quite like the fact that Edge and both Bianca Belair have not announced who they're going to face yet. Let the pay-per-views that are coming up settle and then make the decision. I think that's good.
Yeah, I think so too. I think that's a a really good decision by WWE, because you're right. You know, a lot of the time you can predict where the pay-per-views are going to go.
Yes. Yeah. Absolutely. Absolutely. We had Priest versus Garza, Miz and Morrison ringside, as well as everyone's favourite rapper Bad Bunny. Priest looked strong. All good. Believe he won. Miz and Morrison, did it end in it? I can't remember now. But he looked good. He's looking strong. I do think we're definitely leading to Damian Priest and Bad Bunny versus Miz and Morrison. I know I said last week that the talk was that it was going to be Booker T, but now it's I think it's quite clear that it's going to be Damian Priest and Bad Bunny against Miz and Morrison.
I'm still not mad at it. It's one of them WrestleMania special attraction matches, isn't it? And it's nothing more than that.
Yeah. I think as well, it's worth pointing out that something I read earlier this week. So, especially this side of the pond, a lot of people were like, well, who the hell's Bad Bunny?
Yeah.
He's got 4 t-shirts now on the WWE shop.
Seriously?
They're the 4 top-selling t-shirts on the store. They've sold out. He sold 500,000.
Wow. Jesus.
He's a popular guy, I guess.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So
we get...
You know, okay, we've not heard of him over here. We have now. But he's obviously very, very popular over on that side of the world. So fair play to him. And like we said last week, if he is at the performance center and he's training and he's putting the effort in, he's a wrestling fan, he's living the dream. So fair play to him.
Yeah. He's only doing what the rest of us would love to do.
Would love to do. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, and, no, you think, know, he's been given that platform. I had no idea he had t-shirts on the web on WWE Shop.
Yeah.
But holy shit. I mean, if he's shifting t-shirts like that.
Well, I think it's a t-shirt. So the men's t-shirt, a hoodie, the women's t-shirt, and the kids' t-shirt all sold out.
Wow.
That is unbelievable.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mental.
Yeah. It's crazy. Crazy stuff. So I guess for WWE, getting him in for WrestleMania, that's massive. You know, we're talking about WWE getting back into the mainstream in their own country. It feels like a huge get. It really does.
Yeah, big time.
So.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, yeah, he's clearly one of the biggest sort of, you know, stars that side of the world, you know, for that kind of music. And that's great. Fair play.
Yeah.
He's clearly sort of gotten the desired effect by getting him in.
Yes. Yeah, absolutely. We also had Riddle versus Keith Lee. Good match, good respect between the two at the end of the match.
Yeah,
and then Lashley comes down and just, he's looking like an absolute monster at the minute, and I'm all for it. Attack both of them. So this is it's good. It's the Bobby Lashley we want to see.
Yeah, I think isn't it.
Yes, it is. Yes, that's leading to a triple threat with Lashley defending Riddle and Keith Lee, which again, you know, I think that's going to be great, really great.
Yeah, be a good match, be a really good match, and then probably the most talked about segment or moment of Raw this week. So we had Lana versus Nia Jax, and we were treated to. Probably the most talked about thing in wrestling since Titus O'Neil went sliding under the ring.
Yeah.
And that's not a play on words there. So, Nia goes to do a leg drop on the apron, the hardest part of the ring, as we know. And as she stands up, what does she say, Finn?
My hole!
Ow, my hole.
Let's have that once again, Finn. Let's run that back.
My hole!
Nothing to say, by the way.
Sorry?
Nothing to say.
Yeah.
It makes me wonder whether was she meant to say it? Is it kind of an inside joke? And then it's been picked up by everyone now because... It was said as clear as anything.
I want you to say my hole on TV.
that's all I can take from that match, really. Lana won. She put Nia Jax through a table. Excellent.
After she hurt her hole, yeah.
After, yeah. But this was after Nia Jax hurt her hold.
Okay, so after we had the whole Nia Jax thing, we had Drew versus Orton in a non-title match. Fine, Sheamus came down, caused a distraction. I think the match then got thrown out. So, yeah, another average episode of Raw, I would say.
Yeah, pretty much. But, it, you know, it's the same every week now. We, you know, we talk about it every single week, how bad Raw is and, you know, how does it improve? God only knows. Will it improve?
Who knows?
Same answer. You know, it's just becoming... It's just not an enjoyable show to watch, basically. It'll serve its purpose on the road to WrestleMania. It certainly, you know, is leaning towards like SmackDown is going to have the better of the shows. Because, you know, at the minute, it almost feels like both Raw Rumble winners are actually teasing, challenging the SmackDown champions.
Yeah. It's going to be interesting, I'm sure.
So Raw could be sort of, you know, really having to play catch up to SmackDown. Obviously, that could change. Edge could pick Drew, and
yeah, of course.
You know, it could be, you know, everything could change. But I don't know. I don't know how Raw gets better. I really don't.
Yeah, who knows?
Right, let's move on to Wednesday. I've not had a chance to watch Impact this week, so we'll skip over that. Obviously, we're on the road now, the final road to NXT Takeover Vengeance Day, which is this Sunday.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's looking like a great show as well. That's like, looking like a really good show. I mean, this week's NXT was super strong.
Oh, yeah.
It was a really, really great show. Mm. You know, now we know who's going to be in the final of both Dusty Cups.
Yeah.
Obviously, the title match is all set out, and we are going to get Gargano versus... my mind's gone Kushida. Totally blank. Kushida, yeah. Sorry, I was thinking Nakamura. I was like, that's really bad. But yes, Kushida. That I mean, Johnny Gargano cut a great promo, really funny with Regal as well. But it was just all round. It was a great show. MSK with another fantastic showing this week.
Yeah, Legado del Fantasma, very much.
Yeah, Legado del Fantasma. I mean, I knew it would be. Really good. I knew it would be a great match, and they really delivered, really, really delivered. MSK are going to have an incredible year, I think. I don't think they're going to win on Sunday, but we'll get to that when we do the predictions. Mm. But I do think they're going to have a pretty incredible year.
Yeah,
Xia Li keeps going from strength to strength. I love that storyline.
Yeah, that's badass. That's awesome.
Oh, so badass. Yeah. It's awesome. Yeah, really, really
see
great.
How that goes.
Yeah, definitely. I want to see who the person is who's controlling her and Boa. But I really like that. I think it's great. They're obviously, I mean, that it's super different as well. I mean, there's not much like it in wrestling at the moment. So I really like where that's going, wherever it is going. Xia Li's awesome. Super talented. Super, super talented. Cameron Grimes came back as a GameStop stocks millionaire.
Yeah.
Stonks.
Yeah, Game Stonks. Pretty funny though.
Yeah, everybody.
Yeah, pretty funny.
Yeah.
But it was just another great episode for NXT, really sort of solid, solid all round, really built for this Sunday's show. What? I wanted to just touch on this real quick, just about the ratings. NXT did less than AEW again, but he did less than 600,000 this week. Now, I've seen a lot of people sort of online talking about this and, you know, being really down on NXT and stuff like that. But, you know, more than 1 million people watch this show every week. Two ways about it, you know?
More than a million NXT fans out there. They've got to be watching something. Otherwise, they're going to be fans, right?
Exactly, yeah. So, you know, they're all... There's loads of people watching it week on week because, you know, there's different ways to watch now. There's not just, you know, watching it live or, you know, recording it on VCR or anything like that. Them days are gone. You know, you can watch these shows, you know, on all different platforms. You can watch it, you know, on WWE Network when it comes on there. You can watch it, you know, on demand on whichever, you know, site carries it. You know, BT Sport app over here carries it, and you can watch it on that. Yeah. So it really, you know, the ratings for me are, you know, the ones that we see, they're only sort of the domestic ratings for America anyway when it's going up against AEW, because that's, of course, the narrative they want to work with, the Wednesday Night Wars and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
So it's...
It's one of those things. We touched on it a few weeks ago, didn't we? Yeah, we touched on it a few weeks ago, didn't we? Like, there is so many different forms of entertainment out there now that even your most popular TV shows, away from wrestling, even your most popular TV shows in America, you know, back in the day, like Walking Dead and things like that, they still weren't, they weren't pulling the numbers that TV shows back in the late 90s and early 2000s did, because there is so much choice out there now. Like, if I don't fancy watching TV, I can watch Netflix, Amazon Prime. I've got my Xbox. I can watch WWE Network. I can put my Switch on. There's so much, so many different forms of entertainment out there. I think this, I don't quite understand this obsession with ratings, not in the modern world. It's a little bit like chart music. It's a bit of a farce, because you can get to number one just by doing a campaign and saying, oh, download this song, it'll be really funny. Loads of people do it, it's number one. It means piss all these days, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Nobody's been nothing.
I mean, look at the look at the money that WWE's turned over this year.
Yeah.
By this last financial year.
Exactly.
You know, WWE have recorded record profits. So, you know, yeah, ratings are probably down. You know, but ratings are down everywhere. AEW is not exactly setting the world on fire, but you know that they're doing good ratings and that loads of people watch that show across the world. So for them to, you know, for the people, the internet to go nuts every week saying, oh, AEW beat NXT or NXT beat AEW, it really means nothing, because that's not a true reflection on who is actually watching those shows.
Yeah.
You're absolutely right about, you know, having a fan base across the world as well. AEW were planning on doing a tour in the UK last year. COVID put a stop to that. They wouldn't travel over here if they didn't think they could fill out some form of, you know, small arena, you know, anything like that.
Yeah.
So people around the world do watch this product. It's just how it's watched. And a lot of people watch things illegally as well. Let's be honest, you know.
Yeah.
It's the same thing. People going to the cinema is down compared to 20 years ago because you can get films legally, you know, it's the reality. That's the world these days. So yeah, obsession on ratings.
I don't get it either. I wanted to touch on it. I don't really like talking about it, but you know, it's just not a true reflection. And I think people really need to start to understand that a bit more. Ratings, TV network ratings do not make the world go around.
No, absolutely not.
No, especially, you know, those numbers aren't taken into consideration, fight subscriptions and stuff like that. You know, it's so many different things that have to be taken into consideration, and it just doesn't, they just don't matter as much as maybe they used to back in, you know, the Monday Night Wars days when there wasn't so many options of how to watch things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Agreed. So moving on from that. We'll talk Takeover shortly, but we'll just quickly talk about AEW as well.
Okey-dokey.
I thought it was okay this week. I don't think it was setting the world on fire.
Yeah, I think about watching it again. Sorry, internet. But it's too much wrestling. Yeah. But,
no, but I didn't get a chance either. I've seen a few things on Twitter, the, you know, with what's going on with the Inner Circle, as predicted. But that's I've not seen anything else, unfortunately.
It was okay, you know. Joey Janela and Darby Allin had a good match for the TNT Championship. It was maybe a little bit too short, but it was good. The Sammy stuff with the Inner Circle is very interesting. It's probably the most interesting thing on there at the minute, despite the fact that, you know, they've got this, you know, connection with Impact and New Japan. I really like the Sammy Guevara stuff with the Inner Circle. Pac fought Dolph Ziggler's brother in a really a nothing match, because Pac was never going to lose. Yeah. You know, and the main event was a six-man, a tag team match. It was John Moxley and the Murderhawk Monster, Lance Archer, against Kenny Omega and Kenta. And that was fine as well. It was a street fight, maybe a little bit messy, but I thought it was okay.
Yeah.
just okay. I mean, their pay-per-view is quite a distance off yet. So, you know, I feel like they're not really building to anything and they're really having to sort of stretch things out a bit. But, you know, it wasn't a bad show by any stretch. I thought it was good. I thought NXT was better again this week. I do. But it was, AEW was a good show. It is always consistently good. It's never bad.
No, NXT was especially good this week, so it would have been hard to beat, I think.
Yes, definitely. Yeah, I totally agree with that. I'm not trying to shit on, you know, any promotion, but NXT was the better Wednesday night show this week if we were to compare, for sure.
Yeah,
but both good, both worth a watch. Cool. Let's quickly breeze through SmackDown before we do the NXT predictions.
It was good.
It was good again. Roman Reigns starts to show off as he always does. His entrance takes about 3 ad breaks up. Sure. But
needs new music.
Yeah. No, I agree. I think he needs new music as well. Yeah, definitely. But I don't think it's going to happen anytime soon, do you?
Probably not.
Doesn't seem that way, at least.
Yeah.
No, there was talk of it happening, wasn't there? There was going to be a new music, a new look. There's kind of a new look, but you know, he's got rid of the stab vest or whatever it is. But there was talk of new music that would kind of coincide with this Samoan dynasty thing, but that hasn't happened. I thought it would have happened by now.
Yeah.
Maybe it's a WrestleMania thing.
Maybe. I think it's long overdue, to be honest, but we'll keep an eye on that one. But he, you know, he had another great segment on Raw with Adam Pearce, obviously deciding what would happen at the Elimination Chamber. Would he defend the championship inside the chamber? No is the answer to that question. Instead, we're going to have 6 men go at it in the chamber, and the winner will then go on to face Roman Reigns. I can't remember if they mentioned it or not. Is that match going to be at the Elimination Chamber as well?
Yeah. They're going to have that match first, and then the main event will be Reigns versus whoever.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, okay. Well, that works for me. So that's going to be good. I mean, we've got Cesaro, Daniel Bryan, Jey Uso, Kevin Owens, and 2 other people
Corbin
in there.
And Sami Zayn.
Corbin and Sami Zayn, yep. And they were determined sort of through matches throughout the night. It was good. I like the Apollo Crews and Big E stuff that's going on. I like the way that they sort of interact with one another. I think that's really good. Apollo obviously cost Nakamura a shot at the IC title this week. But it played into the bigger picture story, which, of course, is going to be Apollo versus Big E, which I'm all for. Apollo looking very, very good at the minute. But, yeah, SmackDown was good. At the end, you know, you had a bit of a brawl between everybody who's going to be in that Elimination Chamber match. And Kevin Owens stunned everybody and stood tall at the end of SmackDown. So another good showing for SmackDown.
Of course, they had Seth Rollins and his weird plastic suit. got his all edges theme. And yeah, addressed everyone. Looked like it might have been turning face, but nope. Still an arsehole. Everyone walked off. Left Cesaro there on his own. It looked like Cesaro might have been joining Seth, but no, he walked off and he got beaten up by Seth.
Yeah, so it looks like we're going to get a Seth versus Cesaro feud, which I'm all for.
Yeah, that'd be awesome. I'm glad Cesaro's getting pushed, finally.
I'm not sure if the change of music is the right way to go.
Yeah, I liked his old Jesus music, but I don't know, maybe it's just a 1 week thing. Maybe we'll get that back to make everyone think it's turning face. And then it's like, I'm still Jesus.
Yeah. Hopefully. I hope that's the case, because I don't think the Burn It Down really suits the heel character.
No, I don't think so either.
No.
So yeah, another good episode of SmackDown. The thing with SmackDown, it's a good length. That's what she said.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. But yeah, so it's a good length, and you know, there's, you know, everything on the show is, you know, sort of cohesive and makes some sort of sense. Bianca Belair still hasn't made a decision, which is also good. And the one thing I do fear is that we're going to have Sasha and Bianca challenging Nia and Shayna for the women's tag team titles.
Yeah, that'd be fine.
but that would be such a typical WWE thing to do. It really would.
Yeah, it would.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it would. Let's move on to NXT TakeOver predictions. Like I said before, we are going to be live the pre-show, before the pre-show, 10 o'clock on the Powered 4 TV and Games and Graps Facebook pages.
Yeah.
So we'll talk through the matches more in depth, give our predictions again, and just, you know, generally have another episode of Games and Graps podcast, but live.
Exactly. It'll be good.
Yeah. So, Finn, have you got the card up?
Yeah, NXT card. I sure don't. I was looking for it earlier. I couldn't see it on WWE.com.
That really doesn't bode well, does it?
Yeah, I mind it. There, will it?
Wikipedia. That's what you want.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, here we go. So we've got Johnny Gargano versus Kushida for the North American Championship.
Yeah, I think I'm going to go for Kushida to win the championship here. I think that's a long time coming, and I think that's definitely that would be the best way to go, in my opinion. So yeah, I'm going to go for Kushida.
Cool.
New champion.
Oh, it'd be cool. I'm going to go with Gargano, just to be different.
Okay.
I like the way and everything that's going on at the minute. I think he keeps it just a little bit longer.
Okay.
Yeah, Steve?
I'm gonna go for Kushida as well.
Mm.
Cool. I think it'd be good to see him as the champ and whether it'll get defended at WrestleMania weekend, who knows? But it'd be good to see him take it into that sort of realm.
Mm.
Yeah,
I agree.
Absolutely. And then we've got MSK versus the Grizzled Young Veterans for the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic Finals.
I'm gonna go for Grizzled Young Veterans here, but only because they lost last year.
Yeah, it's going to be a great match, no doubt.
I can't wait.
Yeah, we're MSK because they're new, and they're on fire right now.
They really are. Yeah. I'd like to see either team win, but yeah, Grizzled Young Veterans for me.
Cool,
Steve.
I'd like to see MSK win it as the new tag team. Really. You know, put them out there and introduce them as we are the best young tag team going and all of that. Grizzled Young Vets obviously lost it last year. It's really hard to pick. I think it'd be a great match. I'm going to go with MSK. It's what I said yesterday. So I'll go with that. I have a feeling I'm going to be wrong.
Okay.
Cool. That's it. And we've got the women's Dusty Rhodes Classic. Dakota Kai and Raquel Gonzalez versus Ember Moon and Saty Blackheart.
Yep, I could only see one winner here. That's Dakota Kai and Raquel Gonzalez.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, like Emily Moon and Saty Blackheart. But yeah, I agree. Dakota Kai, for sure.
Yeah. Clean sweep then for Dakota Kai and Raquel Gonzalez. But yeah, I think that's definitely the way they'll go.
For sure. And then we've got Io Shirai versus Toni Storm versus Mercedes Martinez in Triple Threat Women's Championship match.
Yeah, I'm going to go for... I'm going to go Toni Storm. I think she's going to win the championship.
Ooh, nice. I'll be okay with that.
Yeah, I just think they've got a lot of stock in her. She's great in the ring. She's got a great look. And I think it could be time for Rio to move on.
Yeah, is he on the main roster?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Maybe even challenge Oscar at WrestleMania for the title. I'd love that.
Ooh, that'd be awesome. Yeah, that'd be so good. Yeah. It won't happen because it's brought.
But yeah, of course, yeah.
It would be awesome.
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah, I'm going to say Io keeps it for now.
Okay.
Yeah.
Steve?
Yeah, I'm going to go with Toni Storm as well. It's time to put the belt on her. Io's fantastic. Agree with you, Sonny. Maybe it's time to put Io up to the main roster.
Yeah. Yeah, I think so. I just think it's time. I really do. Yeah.
Yeah. Talking of that, we've not seen Rhea Ripley on the main roster yet, have we? I thought we would by now after the Royal Rumble.
I think you're looking at maybe the Raw after Elimination Chamber.
Yeah. Is it going to be a women's Elimination Chamber match?
Yeah. Apparently not. Apparently not.
No. That's rubbish, isn't it?
I think you can overkill it, though, can't you? If you have two is probably still overdoing it, but.
Three in a night.
Yeah. So probably not.
Yeah. Okie dokie. And then we've got the main event, which of course will be Finn Balor versus Pete Dunne, which will be...
Oh, I can't wait. I really can't wait. My heart says Pete, but my head says Finn Balor. And I think Finn Balor will keep that belt until WrestleMania, and he'll lose it to Karrion Kross at WrestleMania.
Yeah, I'm going to stick with Finn Balor as well. Because, yeah, I would love to see Pete Dunne as NXT champion. Hopefully, he will be one day, but I don't know it's going to happen yet. So I'm going to stick with Finn Balor.
Yeah, smart choice. It's going to be a great match. I really cannot wait. It's going to be a hell of a showcase between the two of them. You know, I just can't wait. It's going to be brilliant. That whole show looks awesome. I mean, it looks so good.
Yeah,
so good. Can't wait.
Yeah, I'm going to go Finn as well. I agree with you too. It's he takes that into that WrestleMania weekend. If it's to be believed that it's going to be defended at WrestleMania rather than a takeover show, then Balor is unfortunately that bigger name for your mainstream or your kind of casual WrestleMania audience.
Yes, definitely.
As opposed to Pete Dunne, which is a shame because we know how good Pete Dunne is, and everyone else knows how good Pete Dunne is. But Balor's your name that you probably want taking that.
Yes, yeah, definitely. Yeah. I completely agree with that. But it's going to be a great show. Don't forget to join us tomorrow, 10:00 on Facebook. For the pre-show, before the pre-show. We're really looking forward to that. It was great last time, so we hope to see a few of you there again. But for now, yeah, I think that's probably about it for this week, isn't it, gentlemen?
I think so.
All right. So this has been episode 131 of the Games and Graps podcast. We are a weekly video game and wrestling podcast that posts either Saturday, Sunday, or Monday, whenever it comes out, across podcast services everywhere.
Everywhere.
And youtube.com/gamesandgraps. Steve is definitely on a delay right now. But yeah, we'll see you on the pre-show before the pre-show. But we'll be back next week with a brand new episode of the podcast. Catch you later, guys.
Yes. Thank you much. Goodbye.
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 You're welcome, ladies and men.